Everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I am doing a video with my friend April from Harku Beauty, whose channel and video will be linked down below. I am doing it a couple days later because I have already pre-filmed this, but I lost all footage. I lost all footage of all of the videos that I have pre-filmed. Anyway, leaving all of this tragedy aside, today we are doing our final 2014 favorites video, and it's all about our favorite YouTube channels. So I am going to start out with April's channel, because April has a channel called Harku Beauty, and this channel is definitely one that's worth checking out. April does beautiful videos. They're very kind of creative, I feel, and her tutorials are always very colorful and very, you know, professionally done. She's an amazing makeup artist. She's also a freelance makeup artist, so this is actually her actual job, not just, you know. April's channel is definitely amazing. She herself is just so welcoming, so nice. She's not prejudiced. She looks at everyone and gives everyone a chance, regardless to the number of subscribers that they may have, regardless to where they come from, regardless to anything. She's very welcoming, and for that I really have a huge amount of respect for her. She's definitely an amazing woman, and I definitely recommend checking her channel out. The second lady that I want to talk about is called Sarah from Not Your Typical Dollface. She is the queen of high-end makeup. She does a lot of amazing hauls. Her tutorials are always very bold. She's such a bold woman, I feel. She always wears those really bold, lipsticks. She can even rock like blue or green lipsticks like no other. I can't do that. I feel very self-conscious when I wear a color like that. But I mean, for that, I have a huge amount of respect. Very respect that woman. I really do. She always ends her videos with 3 points of positivity, which I think is just amazing, because everybody needs that kind of positive vibe, especially because sometimes, you know, you might be going through, you know, crappy stuff in your life, but then you hear someone telling you a positive story and that just brightens your day up. It always does for me. And I just think that her videos are just amazing. I really love her. And just like April, she is very welcoming. She's very friendly. I feel like she's always a friend, no matter who you are, no matter what you're going through. She's always on your side. She's always supportive. She's always friendly. And that I just adore about her. So moving on to the third person, her name is Ghada from Patchouli. Yes, Superwoman. We're talking about Superwoman right here. This woman has 8 kids. She does YouTube channel. She has an English degree. I love Patchouli. I love Ghada. Ghada is originally from Egypt, so she's Egyptian. And of course, she has that Egyptian beauty that all of us just want. She's amazing. Her voice is just so soothing. Her reviews are always so thorough. She's amazing. Do you get how much I love her? Moving on to my fourth person, who is Marissa Roy. Marissa Roy is a friend of mine, I would like to say. I would like to call her a friend, because I think of her as a friend. We did do a collaboration in 2014 all about starting with makeup. We did a makeup starter kit, we did a makeup starter tutorial, and we did a video all about whether you should be, you know, starting with makeup or not. So I got to know her quite a lot through that. She also does amazing videos, and she's been taking a break from YouTube for a couple months right now, but I have a strong faith in the fact that she will be back. And she will be like strongly back. Her beauty reminds me of Scarlett Johansson for some reason. I'm not sure if it's like something that many people say that about her, but for me, she's definitely a Scarlett Johansson type of girl. She's beautiful. I really love her. And she's so kind and she's so sweet. And I just highly recommend you check out her channel and subscribe to her and kind of, you know, make her feel like she's been missed, because she definitely has been missed, at least in my opinion. Moving on to my fifth person, Jane from Feverous Aesthetica. Yes, we've reached a point in this video where I feel like this woman is, I don't know, she's obviously, I love her as much as I love all of the other women, but she has a channel that I think can potentially be the most groundbreaking channel ever. Like, her videos, they are always so comprehensive. She always makes a point. Nothing she says will kind of leave you with questions, leave you wondering what she means. She's always very, very clear about what she says. Her reviews are always, always very clear. She makes points in every tiny little kind of word that she says. I feel like she's the most eloquent person, and her tutorials are always very, very kind of I wouldn't call them easy because they definitely show that she has quite a lot of skills in her makeup application. But it's always easy to follow through, and it's always kind of easy to try and recreate, but she's just amazing. I love Jane. Moving on to my sixth person, her name is Isabella, and her channel is called Miss Effortlessly Chic. Miss Effortlessly Chic is a channel that does a lot of reviews, mostly skincare reviews, because she likes to keep her makeup very mainstream. She doesn't like to have 1,000 blushes and 1,000 eyeshadow quads and 1,000 lipstick and 1,000 foundations. She likes to keep everything mainstream. So she always makes sure that she uses things up. Unlike many YouTubers, I feel like they just have products that they've never actually even used, but she actually uses the stuff that she has. She makes amazing, amazing reviews. She always does videos about, fashion. She always does videos about how to choose your sunglasses, how to choose your handbag, how to choose your this and that and this and that. She's very, very stylish. She's very, very chic, and she's very smart. She always knows kind of the backstory of YouTube, the backstory of kind of sponsorship, the backstory of everything. I think she works in marketing or something like that because she's very, very smart, and she's very knowledgeable in that field, at least in my opinion. And moving on to my seventh person, and now we're starting with like more kind of famous YouTube channels. I have to talk about Karima McKinney. She's Australian. She does the most exquisite tutorials. Her tutorials are like, on a league of its own, because she's just very comfortable with colors, yet she always knows how to make that color look wearable. She always knows how to make that look just, glamorous out there, yet something that you feel comfortable wearing, if that makes any sense. I genuinely think that her channel is worth checking out. She is genuinely a YouTuber that I can just watch and watch and watch and watch. She also did a video about her favorite face and eye brushes, and I just was all over those videos. I was just obsessed. I kind of wanted to buy each and every brush that she talked about, but genuinely speaking, me buying Suku brushes, it's not even possible. I will never do that. I don't think, at least, because those brushes, goodness, they cost an arm and a leg and like a head and a neck and a back and an ass. That's what they cost. I genuinely don't think I will ever be buying those brushes, but she's just so fancy, chic, and just, I love her. Moving on from her to Nikki Tutorials. Of course, Nikki Tutorials, she's the one with the most bold, the most colorful, the most professional tutorials ever, hence the name Nikki Tutorials. I think she lives in Holland or somewhere around that area in Europe, and she is just like, she has talent leaking out of her ears and nose and mouth and everywhere, like pores even. She has talent written on her forehead, tattooed on her forehead. She's just so talented. The tutorials that she makes, they're just, I just can't. I will definitely leave her channel down below if you haven't checked her out, but you should, because the tutorials that she makes, I can't. I just, no. Moving on from Nikki Tutorials to Viviana Does Makeup. Beautiful makeup, very, very chic and daytime friendly, neutral. She's exactly the opposite of colorful, I feel. But that's exactly what makes her appealing to me because, I do like monochrome, in my wardrobe at least. I love to wear black and gray and all of those neutral shades. I always feel like she's someone that I can kind of associate with. I can associate myself with her, can associate myself with her style. I definitely love her makeup reviews. I definitely love her tutorials because they're always, always, always on the simple side, but on the chic side as well. So it's kind of simple, chic, effortless, yet really, really beautiful at the same time. So yeah, that is that. And then my final person for the year happens to be Kathleen Lights. Kathleen Lights is another one of those big channels on YouTube. She does phenomenal, phenomenal, phenomenal tutorials. Her reviews are always on point. She's very beautiful. I like her attitude. She always feels like your friend does on YouTube. I feel like what she does can potentially lead her to even better and greater things in the future. So yeah, that is that. And I believe I talked about 10 YouTubers right now. I definitely have more YouTubers in my mind and I love them so much. I did not talk about my picks in a hierarchical order. So number one wasn't necessarily number one and number 10 wasn't necessarily number 10. All of these I love equally. Some are my friends, some I feel are definitely friends of mine. So definitely it was just such a fun video to make, and I hope that you check all of these channels out. Having a small YouTube channel is okay, because everybody starts small, and to be honest, it's not even about the quantity, it's about the quality, it's about how you feel about what you do, it's about how much passion you have for what you do, and how much you kind of try to connect with others. Because you know, I did this to find people that share the same passion that I have. And I definitely feel like I'm starting to find those people. I'm starting to make friends here on YouTube, and it's just such an amazing thing. So if you are thinking about doing a YouTube channel, definitely do that. Definitely, definitely do that. And don't feel discouraged or kind of disheartened about YouTube just because you haven't made a billion subscribers yet. So anyway, thank you so much for watching. I definitely encourage you to check out April's channel and check out the videos that we did together, because I think that they were definitely some of the best videos I've ever done in my life. Thank you so much, April, for collaborating with me. It was just such an honor. Again, thank you everyone for watching. Definitely check out April's channel. Definitely subscribe to both mine and hers. Give us some thumbs up and definitely leave us your comments down below. And if you have a YouTube channel that I'm not aware of, definitely tell me, because I'd love to check it out. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye. Mwah.